Okay, we're going to do the jumper for the x-axis. Now we have to review some stuff real quick here. We have the MS1, 2, and 3 sets of pins. If you place a jumper on any of these pins, you'll change the actual rotation of the stepper motor. So if there are no jumpers, it would give you a complete 360 degrees. If you have a jumper on MS1 only, then that would give you a half step. If you had only a jumper on MS2, it would give you a quarter step. If you have a jumper on MS1 and MS2, that would give you 1/8 of a step. And if you have all three, then it would give you 1/16 step. And seeing how that we're doing a 3D printer, we want the precision, so we're gonna cap all three of these with jumpers. Now, careful with the jumpers, they're kind of hard to get in place. Now, let me talk briefly about stepper drivers. This is a stepper driver. It's called a A4988. It's got a potentiometer to adjust the amount of current that goes to the motor. Now this potentiometer, you can use usually a non-metallic Phillips head type and turn it to either increase it or decrease it. I'll let you look that up. But in this particular stepper, you always have to have the potentiometer pointing away from the power supply. And this gives you 1/16 steps. This is a DRV8825, and this will allow 1/32nd steps in the current configuration we're in. And the potentiometer is over here. Now, when you plug this in, it has to point towards the power supply. So for simplicity, we're gonna start with this one, and we're gonna just insert it into these pins. Just apply a little pressure to push it down. Now, because we're using an end stop, the first thing that we want to do to make it so that we can test it real easy is we also want to insert the X end stop for minimum. So this is min X. And then for the motor, we need a connector for that. Some of these motors will come with wires coming out already. But in this case, this particular motor uses it. Also, motors can either be 1.8 degrees of step, which would give you 200 steps in a 360 degree rotation. And then we also have a motor that can do 0.9 steps, which means that you get 400 steps. But for simplicity's sake, we're just going to use a stepper motor that does 1.8 degrees of step. Connected the USB for the board side for the Arduino Mega 2560. We need to also connect it to the computer. So to do that, we plug in the other end into the USB of the computer and hopefully hear a beep saying it worked. Which it did. Okay, we're going to open up Marlin. This is the firmware. Okay, now inside Marlin, we're going to go to configuration. And we're going to scroll down to where the stepper settings are. Okay, so this is the configuration that's default for the steppers. So as you can see above here, this is your X, this is your Y, this is your Z,
and this is your E0. Right here is E0. Now it means you can also add other steppers. They show you the default way to do it over here. But what we're going to be concerned with is actually changing no values for the moment and just loading it and then seeing what occurs. So first thing we're going to do is check to see that we're connected. So it looks like we're on COM3. Looks like we have the right board selected and subtype. So let's compile and load. Okay, now it's uploaded.
Hooked up and we're about to start Pronaface. We got to add power from the power supply, so we're going to plug in the 12 volt power supply. Looks like everything's okay at the moment. Let's check the end step real quick here. That works fine.
Now we're going to open up Pronaface. Okay, we're going to connect to the device now that we have the Marlin firmware loaded. The first thing we want to try is to do home to X. So while we're doing home to X, we're going to actuate the sensor to let it know that it's reached its end stop. So watch the motor.
So we've found the home.
So now that we've found the home, we're going to advance by 100. Now that we've advanced by 100, we're going to go back by 100. Appears to work perfectly fine. So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.